the staff isn't having any effect. No!
Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
We've navigated the hazards of the Chardak.
What's the worst that could happen? Well, you could have your mind sucked dry by Hermaeus Morloth. But that's supposed to be very rare.
With the help of Naloth and Nematis, we have opened the Black Book casing. And now it's time for
Aren't
me
you
to
going
read
to read it? I thought that was the whole reason you dragged me out here.
It is the whole reason, but give me a moment. All right, here we go.
Oh, good. Be sure to say hello to Hermaeus Morloth for me if you...
Oh, no! Where am I?
I know you, champion. The Agma Infinium was only the beginning.
You?
This is Apocrypha, where all knowledge is hoarded. Sate to your thirst for knowledge in the endless stacks of my library. If you tire of the search, read your book again to return to your mortal life. For a time, the lure of Apocrypha will call you back. It is your fate. Jump in here. What? This doesn't feel safe. And of course, Naloth and the Nematis were left behind. I see another one of those things. I think I need to activate it. Oh, look at those tentacles. This is certainly the land of Hermaeus. Oh! Of Hermaeus Morloth. On my own. All right, this thing is coming back. I need to get on it. Oh! Okay. Wait, maybe it's gonna take me. Hold on. I probably needed to get off on that location. Here. Oh.
All right, another book. Chapter 2. What's this? Some sort of a vortex. Is this a play on words, text? Spinning in a circle, a vortex? What is that sound? That's not my footsteps. Maybe it is. See what I can do. How many of these are there? No, the staff isn't having any effect. The staff, or choose a different one. No, these staffs, they're not charged. Alright, help me! Help me! No, paralysis doesn't work either. Here. All right, and looks like it's this way. All right, good. You stick with me. Hold on, there might be something I can get from this creature. Oh, it's so hideous. Plenty of gold, though. Looks like another book. Chapter 3. I wonder how many chapters there are. Oh no, I see another one of those creatures. Anything here that I needed to check out? This doesn't look good. Another creature. All right, I think we have to get on this. Come on, oh no! Well, I can resummon him if necessary. All of this is just so strange and frightening. Can't get through. Oh, no. A Chimer Vomitium. Not sure what that is. Oh!
I got it. It's particularly vulnerable to this dark magic. Oh, no! Oh. All right, come on, let's go. There's more of those things.
The Challenger! There you are, weakling!
What? Help! Got them! We did it! Alright, watch out. I'm sure some tentacle is gonna pop out of that. And that. And that. I think I made it to the next chapter. This should be chapter 4? Yes, let's go. Okay. Chapter 3. All right, you're with me. Good. Some despair, we'll take that. Gold. Alright. This might be it. The end of our journey. The epistolary acumen.
Well done, my champion. Your journey towards enlightenment has finally led you here to my realm, as I knew it would.
Are you saying that you had me poisoned? So that I would come here seeking a cure? This was all orchestrated by you? What
do you want of me?
You have entered my realm. You have sought out the forbidden knowledge that only one other has obtained. You are dragonborn, like Mirak before you, a seeker of knowledge and power.
No. You tricked me. You poisoned me. So I would come here. I'm not seeking power. All I want is a cure so I can live my life. But I am here to learn how Mirak did this to me.
All that he knows, he learned from me.
Of course.
I know what you want. To use your power as Dragonborn, to bend the world to your will. Here, then, use the knowledge you need, although you did not know you needed it.
What?
The second word of power. Use it to bend the wills of mortals to your purpose. But this is not enough. Mirak knows the final word of power. Without that, you cannot hope to surpass him.
What?
Mirak served me well. And he was rewarded. I can grant you the same power as he wields, but all knowledge has its price.
Why do I need this word of power to defeat Mirak?
Even dragons submit to Mirak's voice. Without that power, you cannot face him. So say I, Hermaeus Mora, master of the tides of fate.
But isn't Mirak your ally? Ally? Why help me defeat him?
He has served me long and well, but he grows restless under my guidance. His desire to return to your world will spread my influence more widely, but it will also set him free from my direct control. It may be time to replace him with a more loyal servant. One who still appreciates the gifts that I have to offer.
Gifts like reversing my advanced aging and my magicka poisoning? So what is the price for the final word of power?
Knowledge. For knowledge. The Skaar have withheld their secrets from me for many long years. The time has come for this knowledge to be added to my library.
And what if the Skaar refuse to give up their secrets?
My servant Mirak would have found a way to bring me that I want. So will you, if you wish to surpass him. Then the Skarl Shaman told me he holds the secrets that will be mine.
What's the book doing? Dragonborn Force. Dragonborn Flame. Or Dragonborn Frost. So, I guess this is going to be my unrelenting force shout. Yes, does more damage and may disintegrate enemies. Well, since I don't use any of the other shouts, and this is the only one that I use occasionally, I'll take it. Alright, Dragonborn Force. Alright. Val, whatever your name is, it's time to go.
What happened? What did you see? Different people have very different experiences when reading these books.
I talked to Hermaeus Mora.
You're still acting surprisingly sane, too. What did he have to say? He must have wanted something from you.
He wants the secrets of the Skarl in exchange for teaching me the third word. And perhaps curing me of this magicka poisoning.
Ah, what secrets could they have worth keeping from old Mora? Sounds like a bargain to me. Hermaeus Mora learns some fascinating new ways to skin a hawker, and you become the second most powerful dragonborn that ever lived. Well, that gives me a lot to think about. I need to get back to Telmithrin. I have some ideas about how to locate more of these black books.
All right, well, I appreciate your help. So far, you didn't have to do this. And as rude as you can sometimes be and condescending, you seem to be a good man. All right, let's go, Nematis.
Is someone there?
What? Right, where is it? Got it! To do this, especially in my condition?
I've heard that you can sell Dwemer artifacts on the black market down in Cyrodiil. They fetch a handsome price, too.
All right, we need to get out of here. What happened to, Naloth?
think we need to talk to Storn first. Let's go.
I'm sure there's a good reason Baldur left us.
Something isn't right for me. I feel it in my bones and I smell it in the air. Baldur wouldn't leave without telling someone.
Don't right worry yourself for nothing, Beorn. Do you want a head full of gray hairs before you've seen 40 winters?
It makes my heart heavy that you don't believe me, Fenari. Baldur could be in danger and you will do nothing. If you won't help me, then I'll ask the Allmaker to send someone else who can.
Excuse me.
I am in no mood to talk, outsider. One of the Skull has gone missing.
Who? Who's missing?
It is Baldur Ironshaker.
No!
As our only smith, Baldur is very important to the village.
I bet he is. Did anything unusual happen around the time of his disappearance?
I do not remember Baldur acting strangely. Although now that you ask, I did see something in the woods on the day he disappeared. I saw two elves in the far distance dragging something behind them. Hunters often visit our land, so I thought little of it.
Where were they headed?
South and west. If your road takes you that way, perhaps you could search for any sign of Baldur. The Skull would be grateful.
All right. Okay, Nematis. Let me go and talk to Skjorn, whatever his name is. I feel so bad about doing this. It's like I'm exchanging my life for the Skull's secrets. Storn?
So the dragons have returned. Well, the Skull have survived worse.
I spoke with Hermaeus Mora. He asked for the secrets of the Skull.
Hermaeus Mora. Old Herma Mora himself. So he is the source of Mirak's power. Of course. We have many tales of Herma Mora trying to trick us into giving up our secrets to him. And now he comes again for what we have long kept from him.
If I may ask, what are the secrets of the Skull?
Ah, ancient lore, handed down from shaman to shaman since the Allmaker first gave Solstheim to the Skull. How to talk to the wind, how to listen to the earth. These are our secrets. Nothing of power or mastery.
Why would Hermaeus Mora want your secrets?
We know him as Herma Mora, the demon of knowledge. It is in his nature to hoard secrets to himself. Their value to him is of no consequence. The very fact that the Skull have kept knowledge from him has merely increased his desire to have it.
He said it's the only way he'll teach me the final word of Mirak's shout.
So it falls to me to be the one to give up the secrets to our ancient enemy. I do not know if I have the strength to face him. With Mirak's corruption of the stones, the oneness of the land is disrupted, and our connection to the Allmaker is broken.
All right then, I'll restore the remaining stones if that will help.
It may. It should. And I will think on what you ask of me to decide if it is necessary or just another of Herma Mora's tricks. The land is out of balance. Mirak's power still corrupts the sacred stones. Allmaker, shelter you.
All right. We need to go and get the rest of those stones cleansed. Alright, we'll head back to Raven Rock first. Come on, let's go to the Earthstone. I can stop these people from wandering out at night.
Our hands once were idle.
All right, here goes.
Good!
Get back! Everyone! Get back! Look out! Did I hear something else?
God,
what is it?
Over here!
It's another one! Alright, Raven Rock is free. I think we have a couple more of these stones to cleanse. Alright, Nematis. Let's go.